Now to the other big ruling that we got this morning, handed down. This is the ruling on free speech case involving a familiar challenge here. The question whether businesses can refuse service to LGBTQ customers because doing so would violate the business owner's First Amendment rights. This was a 6-3 decision. The Supreme Court rules for a Christian web designer who objected to making wedding websites for same-sex couples.
Today, the last day of Pride Month, the Supreme Court revealed yet another catastrophic decision that favors conservative Christians who want to use their faith as an excuse to discriminate against their fellow Americans. So let's get into some information on the woman who started this whole lawsuit. From CBS News, Lori Smith wants to post a message explaining why she cannot make custom websites for same-sex weddings, which states that doing so compromises her Christian beliefs and tells, quote, a story about marriage that contradicts God's true story of marriage. Colorado's law prohibits businesses open to the public from refusing service because of sexual orientation and announcing their intent to do so. Now, here's the real kicker. Smith has not yet created any wedding websites or been asked to do so for a same-sex wedding, but argues that Colorado's law violates her free speech rights since the state is forcing her to express a message she disagrees with. Now, Smith filed a lawsuit against the state of Colorado and lost, then appealed to the Supreme Court. The ruling has horrifying implications for not just the LGBTQ community, but also other minority groups. So let's learn more.
These public accommodation laws have a lengthy historical pedigree. They've been part of our federal laws for over 70 years. And in most states and localities, there are similar laws. And they just say that if you're a business and you provide goods or services to the public, you can't discriminate. And in recent years, discrimination on the basis of sexual orientation and sometimes gender identity has also been prohibited in many places, including in Colorado. And until now, the Supreme Court has never said that one of those laws violates the First Amendment rights of a business or business owner who wishes to refuse service to some category of customers. So I do think that Devin is exactly right that this case has potentially sweeping ramifications for the ability of business owners under some circumstances to provide services and the ability of customers to receive services on a non-discriminatory basis.
Now, Justice Sonia Sotomayor elaborated on those ideas in her dissent. From the New York Times, the decision threatens to balkanize the market and to allow the exclusion of other groups from many services, Justice Sotomayor wrote, citing hypothetical examples like a stationery store owner refusing to sell a birth announcement for a disabled couple because she opposes their having a child. Or a large retail store could reserve its family portrait services for traditional families. A website designer could equally refuse to create a wedding website for an interracial couple, for example. Meanwhile, here's what Lori Smith had to say today on, of course, Fox News.
I am incredibly grateful for the court's decision that affirms that the government cannot force anyone to say something they don't believe. I want to create websites that are consistent with my view on marriage, but the state of Colorado said you must set aside your views. And I decided to take a stand for freedom, to protect speech. I know that if I want free speech for myself, that I must protect it for others, and I'm grateful that the court has protected speech for all. I have clients from all walks of life, including clients who identify as LGBT, and I just want to create consistent with what I believe, but I want that for everyone. I want the LGBT website designer, the Jewish calligrapher, the Democrat speech writer. I want everyone to be able to work and design consistently with what they believe.
She looks exactly how you would expect her to look, by the way. Just had to point that out. Now, thankfully, there's clever Twitter users who've already thought of how to turn the Supreme Court's insane rulings against them. Here's a tweet from feminist longtime Elon Musk fan, not real. It says, it is my deeply held belief that my loan servicers are homosexuals and it would violate my religious freedoms to pay them. Gotta laugh. Gotta laugh so that we don't cry, right, Jake?
Yeah, well, that's creative. I like that one. Okay, so now let's talk about two things. One is the legality of the ruling. Are they on solid legal ground? That's totally different than the policy implications. We'll save that for a second. So on legal ground, this is a disastrous case. And I think that they're gonna regret this. And I don't mean it in terms of the policy grounds and the religion grounds. Most of the people on the Supreme Court, unfortunately, are Christian fundamentalists, and they're not gonna regret that part at all. but they're gonna regret just wiping out the concept of legal standing. So this woman is actually not a web designer. She did not have a business. She didn't have any customers. So by the way, on that Fox News appearance, she's like, oh, I have LGBT customers. You do? Then why'd you bring this case? You don't have any customers, you're lying. But it's worse than that. Journalists found out that she listed someone who she said, well, okay, don't worry, I got a potential customer. That's not a real thing, okay, in the case of legal standing, which I'll explain in a second. And then a reporter called the theoretical potential customer, and he's like, what are you talking about? I'm a web designer. I don't need another web designer. Get married. I'm already married. Gay. I'm straight. I have a kid. What is this? She just made up her potential customer. Made it up out of whole cloth. Look, guys, that's why I tell you, I'm not like, it's not hyperbole. The right wing lies all the time as a matter of course. If a right winger is speaking that's in any way, I don't mean average person, I mean like politicians, pundits, people doing lawsuits, etc. If they're speaking, there's an excellent, overwhelming chance they're lying, okay? So now why does this matter? Because you have to have what's called standing to bring a case. I explained this in the first hour. If Bob and Joe are fighting and Bob caused Joe harm, Joe can sue Bob. I can't sue Bob, I got nothing to do with that case. Otherwise, we'd all be suing for things that we're not involved in, right? That's why the issue of legal standing is a bedrock of jurisprudence, right? And they just wiped it away. She doesn't have any standing at all. She has nothing to do with providing services for LGBTQ people. So okay, that means if she can sue, anyone can sue for anything, even if they're not at all affected. I wanna see you be principled, Supreme Court. So you, okay, go apply this precedent. You're not gonna do it. You're gonna lie next time and go, oh, did we say that in that case? Yeah, well, it's only for that case, only for that case. Now that other people have done it and it's not along our political ideological lines, we're gonna go back to the real precedent on standing. So this is just butchering legal principles, butchering them. They're not even trying to pretend to be fair. Okay, now in terms of the policy, okay, so now we can discriminate on religious grounds. So does that mean whether it's baking a cake or any other service? So if they say, oh, bar mitzvah, I'm not doing that, a bunch of Jews. No, I don't agree, I'm Christian, I'm evangelical, I'm Pentecostal, whatever it is, right? But it has to be, you know, they're normal Pentecostals, it said Christians wouldn't do this, but fundamentalists would, right? So they're like, no, the Jews, I don't serve them. Muslims, oh hell no. No, they're getting no service at all. So we're back to, you can't sit at the diner counter, right? So now instead of race, although it could be racist, Sotomayor pointed out, because a lot of the religious texts do differentiate based on race. But if they didn't even want to go there, but they could at least say, you're a Jew, get out. You're a Muslim, get out. Buddhist, get out. By the way, Muslims can say it to Christians, Jews can say it to Muslims. This is gonna turn into a S show. This is gonna be a disaster.
They didn't just start doing away with legal standing today. This is the second time in a week they did it. The states that brought the student loan cases didn't have standing. Standing doesn't matter to this court. Nothing matters to this court except for religious principles. They're conservatives, blue-eyed, blonde, Jesus principles. So don't get it confused with the nappy-headed Jesus that look more like you, Cenk, than, you know, Tom Cruise or somebody. No, we're not talking about that. You gotta be racist to be a Republican, period. I don't wanna hear anybody saying anything else. My religion says I can't serve Republicans. I'm about to open up a business in every market and discriminate like hell. What are we doing? This is no longer can we say America has a democracy as long as we continue to allow the Supreme Court to show up in this manner.
Yeah, and I just want to add that to that point you made about them, you know, undoing standing. You know, this isn't even the first time this week they've done it. They really started laying the groundwork last year when they made a decision about, you know, how companies in West Virginia could sue to prevent the EPA from enacting some future hypothetical law to curb greenhouse gas emissions. And just again to that point, you know, that Cenk was making. Also, I feel like I graduated law school a month and a half ago, and I took con law a year and a half ago, and everything I've learned in con law has already gone out the window. It's like the things I've learned about the law are already useless. But you know, Cenk, you were talking about how they, how there wasn't even a gay couple that was asking for her services. She wasn't even a web designer. But so let's talk about that really briefly, because Melissa Grant, who's a staff writer at the New Republic, really, you know, cracked open this case and published her findings with this article that says, "The mysterious case of the fake gay marriage website, the real straight man, and the Supreme Court." Now we can watch here explain what she found out to Amy Goodman of Democracy Now.
Later filing in that original case in 2016, she claimed that an actual same-sex couple sought to have her build a website for them. That an inquiry, it doesn't seem that it was a legitimate inquiry, but it remained in the case. It came up in the district court ruling that ruled against her. It came up in their appeal. It's even been included in filings to the Supreme Court and was referenced by her attorneys, Alliance Defending Freedom, who are a Christian nationalist law project. I just saw this phone number in a filing and I thought, well, let's call this guy, right? Let's see if this is a real inquiry. Well, he's not in Colorado. I learned that right away. You know, it is a real person's name. It is a real person's phone number. It is a real person's email address. It is a real person's website. But when I called that real person, and it wasn't hard to reach him, he was happy to talk to me. He's a very reasonable, nice guy who had no idea that his information was in this case, and he had never heard about it from another reporter. No one had ever called him to check this inquiry out, which would suggest also that the attorneys in this case did not reach out to him to verify this.
He is married to a woman, has a child, and had no plans to have a gay marriage, and never, he said, submitted any request to this woman who doesn't make marriage websites to make him a gay marriage website.
Not at all. And you know, I looked into his background. It seems credible. I've been talking with him on and off since the first phone call I made to him on Tuesday.
You know, Cenk, what this really reminds me of is the case that was decided, the free practice of religion case about school, but the coach, the football coach who was doing an egregious act of prayer on the 50-yard line, holding his, you know, up a football helmet, standing next to a state legislator with like 50 kids gathered around him, and the Supreme Court said it was a private act of personal prayer. It really doesn't matter what the actual facts of the case are. They will just lie. They'll just lie.
Yeah, no, look, the funny thing is the first football coach who prayed with the team and then was sanctioned in the old days when the law mattered, that was my football coach from my high school. So in an amazing coincidence. But the second case that Rayvon is talking about, the Supreme Court came in and they're like, oh, he's on his knees praying in the middle of the public school with all the kids. Nope, not prayer. Okay, so we're just now past the fact-based world. And so they could just make up anything they like. And remember, these are the conservatives who said plain meaning of words. Okay, these liberals are activists and they're making things up. So we're sticking with the plain meaning. In the earlier student debt case that Mondale referenced, it says the president can waive or modify the loans. And the Supreme Court came in and said, no, he can't waive them and not really modify them either. Because apparently facts and words have no meaning anymore.
At all. Listen, I couldn't stop laughing to say something because it's so funny that they change the meaning of words as they are saying them. And no one checks them on our side. The left, this is why I feel like we are so bad. The Republicans get in control, or not even in control. They just get elected, it'd be 3 of them and 700 of us, and they just take over because they're just ruthless with whatever they're gonna say and do. If those were liberal justices on the Supreme Court that were taking money from Republican donors or Democratic donors, we would have held them accountable, our side. And we allow Republicans to get away with anything, Republicans including Joe Manchin and Clarence Thomas. So I am disgusted with all of the people that call themselves leftists that are not up in arms about the Supreme Court this week, especially when they were so ready to celebrate the Supreme Court for what they sent back to Alabama as if that was a real victory for us.
Yeah, and by the way, it's a great point by Mondale. Calling George Soros, apparently you can give the liberal Supreme Court justices anything you like. Take him to $1 million vacation. Give him homes, buy their parents homes for way over market price. Do anything you want, because apparently the right wing says, oh, donors buying Supreme Court justices is awesome. Okay, interesting precedent. Now, for the record, we hate all of it. We don't want Soros doing that. We don't want the Republican donors doing it. But the right wingers have, of course, no principles. All they care about is power, mine, facts and reason. Who gives a goddamn? And that's a giant problem for our country. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.